Hello and welcome everyone. Thank you so much for showing so much of, you know, positive response regarding my mentorship sessions. I'm really glad, happy to help all of you. Okay, so we have been discussing a lot in my mentorship sessions, and I've already taken a few mentorship sessions before. Today I'm sharing something with you all. Okay, this is my certificate of merit, as I have. For those who do not know me or watching this mentorship session for the first time, I'm CS Fatima Kagalwala, okay, and I am a faculty teaching here with Jahangir Tutorials. So this is my certificate of merit, and of course I framed it and kept it with me, which states that Fatima Mohammadi Kagalwala has secured a 13th rank in the professional exam June 2016. Okay, date of issue, the signature of the president is there on my this certificate. So I just wanted to show you all this. It was always, I like to share this with my students because I think this can motivate you. I think everybody wants this. I'm sure there cannot be a single student who says, no ma'am, we don't need this. So I'm here to help you, take you to the same place where I have been. Okay, in fact, I would be more glad and overwhelmed if you all are reaching far more ahead than me also, because that is the true thing what a teacher can teach you. Okay, and can we feel blessed that okay, our students are doing really well. Okay, so our motive is to success in the correct manner. Okay, so every mentorship session, as you all know, we are discussing all the valuable tips. We had discussed a lot of things last mentorship. I have given you all some kind of activity also to be done. So we are going to discuss the result of that activity towards the end of the session. Okay. But today I am also going to discuss a very, very valuable tip that will help you get closer to your dream. Okay. More than the dream, I don't know, I will say your aim. Okay, I like to use this word aim, because dreams, unless you do not aim it, it will stay in your dreams only. So for you to achieve the dream, you have to wake up. Okay, so you have to get out from your comfort zone. You have to get up, you have to get going. So let's put this as an aim. Okay, so I'm taking you one step closer towards your aim, and your aim should be that certificate also, which I have just shown you. Okay, so today's valuable tip, all of you all are excited. So please let me know in the comment section. I also want to know the responses, whether you're excited to know what am I going to share with you all today, and you are going to promise me to work on the same manner as I am telling you. Okay, these mentorship sessions are totally free. I am not charging anything. My only charge will be that you're going to pass with flying colors, and you know, be proud of your own selves and make me also proud. So this is the only fees. Otherwise, there is nothing. So if you all are still waiting, please go ahead, join the WhatsApp group. Okay, you will get the timings, you know, and the Zoom link on that WhatsApp group. So be there with me. These sessions are to solve your problems strategically. Study, everybody does. I'm sure you all know your content, and I'm sure you all are very intelligent to understand it conceptually also. Okay, here we are looking at the strategies of getting good marks, clearing with good marks, in fact getting a rank. Okay, so we are aiming to becoming a successful CS. Okay, so our aim is really, really high, and these are certain steps which we have to clear and climb before we reach there, right? So don't wait for anything. Join the WhatsApp groups. I said it is free. Okay, now today's valuable tip, coming to the important thing. Okay, every time, you all must have heard me, I have told you, make notes, write notes, write properly, write in the exams. Okay, now when the results were out, okay, and the few students whom I speak to, or you know, I'm trying to counsel them, what I understand is they know everything very nicely. okay, their concepts are good and clear. What they lack is the writing practice. But they don't know how to write in the paper. So how much ever smart you are, how much ever you have done the revision, or you know, you have known your activity, if you are not going to present that at the time when it is needed in a manner it has to be, you're going to miss it. Okay, so your goal has to be given that kind of a kick. Okay, so when you are studying hard, when you're preparing for your exams, how are you appearing in your exam is important. Okay, so don't forget that. So making of notes and presenting answers is important. So when I say make notes, it gives you a daily writing practice. Remember, a daily writing practice. ICSI is a writing examination. Okay, so if you are coming from CSET with that MCQs, it's done, it's gone. We are having proper written papers now in executive and professional. True. So writing practice is important. Now how that practice will come? Every day you cannot write a paper, no? So every day what you will write? You will write your own notes. Okay. And that you will present in your answers in the exams. So your writing practice is going to come only if you are going to follow these steps. Okay. So choice is yours. Success or failure. It can be a little longer route. It might take a little bit of time. But success is definitely achieved only if you are going a little bit extra. Okay, extraordinary. All the students who were there with me last time knows that. So pay attention. I am going to show you all how to write and make notes and how to present that in the exam also. I'll show you. Okay, because talking to few students and understanding what they have done in the paper, I'm sure you all need to know this first. Okay. So mind mapping, whenever you are studying, okay, whenever you are, say you take any chapter of company law, you are studying that chapter today. So your chapter, first thing, it has to be in your mind, okay, conceptually. Conceptually, you have to understand it. So mind mapping is something that you know the entire chapter in your mind. A flow of the chapter, what this chapter is all talking about. Okay, so that is important. Some students tell me, okay, no ma'am, we just do the mugging up. So that is not going to take you anywhere. If you want to become a successful company secretary, your concepts have to be clear. Mugging up, mug it up, write the exam, you need this only for the degree, you're not going to apply it anywhere, then it is a different thing. But if you are applying, your concepts have to be clear. Okay, so understand any chapter, put that chapter in your mind first. Okay, you have not yet started writing. I'm just giving you the step before you write your notes. Okay, then make one page summary notes. We had discussed important chapters in the last mentorship session. Remember that these chapters are very, very important. So for those chapters, you are supposed to write notes properly. Some chapters which are not that important, you can just make a flowchart of what is given in that chapter, so that any time when question is asked in the exams, you will know what has to be written. Okay, you are not totally blank on that chapter. Always, always study all the chapters. Do not try to bunk any chapter, okay, or omit. Oh, please omit this word from your mind. This word omit. It's not there only. It does not exist for CS. Okay, everything is there. You have to study everything. There are certain chapters not important. They are important for 3 marks, 5 marks. Make a summary note, one page note. Keep it with you. Any question asked from that chapter, you can attempt it. Whenever you are making notes, okay, how do you make notes? First, how did I make my notes? So obviously, I have to know the heading, okay. Always give the heading of whatever topic. Always give the heading of the topic which you are going to write. Correct? With the heading, then in the point form, you can write about what that particular heading is. So you're talking about appointment of directors. Okay. So write appointment of directors. in the side, write the section. Just over here, write the rule. Write it. Writing will make you remember things. See, I have also given the CS exams, like how you all are studying, even I have studied. Okay. So there is nothing like a rocket science thing I have done. Same thing what you all are doing, I am doing. The only difference is I used to write. When we write, we remember. Okay, this is the basic success tip which anybody will give you, and it is the most successful tip. Okay, so when you write, you will write the section, you will write the rule. So when you will again open the book, you will read the section, you will read the rule. And when you will keep reading it and reading it, you will automatically remember. There is no other way to remember sections. Okay, so I used to write my section in the margin. I used to give the write the rule. Everything in short form. Okay, in short forms, I used to give certain points. And then I used to also write certain case law, name of that case law, which is relating to that particular heading. That's it. This was my notes. So my appointment of directors used to get over, like I say, in 10-15 lines. Okay, but I cannot write it in the same manner in my exams. What do I mean by that is, I will write the section, I'll write the rule, I'll write the heading, but everything in full form. Okay, everything. Company law 2013, Companies Act. Some people, you know, I used to write a lot of short forms. You will find them in my videos of my other lectures also, like accounts and FM and all. So yes, short forms you can write when you're making notes, but not in the time when you're writing your exams. It's not allowed. Okay, it's professional exam. You have to behave professionally and write professionally. So this is what I used to do with my notes. So every day I take up one chapter. I should be able to finish the notes. If it is a very, very important chapter, like 20 marks, I will devote good time to that chapter for making the notes also. Okay. Then, so this is like how I used to write my notes. I just told you I used to give a heading, certain pointers, and then one case law which is relating to something like this, appointment of directors, okay, or deposits in case of company law, or charge created, the form number of the charge, creation, satisfaction of charge. So those form names and numbers I used to write. Now this particular thing, when you are writing, okay, you have to present this in the exams. So when I have been talking to students, and the reasons why they have got such bad marks is not any surprise to me. Okay, why? Because I will show you something. I'm going to solve. I have solved a paper for y'all. Okay, so let's first go to that paper. Okay, how to write in the exams and get good marks. Okay, there is a sample question paper. I have taken the model answers and I have written the answers and types of questions. Now see, institute, whenever they give the paper, they have a little bit of a paper pattern. Okay, I'll not say that they follow the paper pattern always, but there are certain types of questions which are generally asked. All right, so you need to understand that type first so that you can write the answer according to the type. All right. Now see this, there are six types of questions maximum. Okay, these are the six types which they ask in any given paper. Apart from accounts and FM, accounts and FM, yes, I'm there with you all. We'll be doing those. You all can join, enroll for the classes, and we are going to do FM accounts again. We are going to do the marathon. So be there with me. Don't be afraid to take help from the right person. Okay. If you will try to take help from different 10 people, you will get 10 opinions and then you will not know what to do. So stick to something which is very comfortable to you and you are able to get something positive out of that. Okay. So these are the six type of questions which generally are asked by the institute. One is comment. Comment are direct questions. Like they will give you some kind of a heading and they will ask you to comment on this heading. Then they will give you a situation and ask you some question on that situation. Some descriptive type of questions which are really lengthy. Then distinguish, very my favorite distinguishes. then some drafting draft, some board resolution or some notice, okay, and sometimes some questions which are practical in nature, so that can be asked relating to say buyback, okay. So some questions can be there which they ask you practically. So now generally I have seen how the students attempt and what are they actually supposed to do. I'll show you. Now this is the question. I have written the question for you all. You all know the content. Very good. I'm very happy. Comment on the following. What is the question? Question number 1. A. Reduction of share capital in and diminution of share capital means the same. This is the phrase they have given. We are supposed to comment and elaborate on this phrase. Now which question it is? Question number 1. In question number 1, sub question A. So first write answer to question number 1A. Write properly. Write it in the margin which is there on the left hand side. Okay, and please do not keep on making lines in the paper. Okay, I've seen students, they keep on making lines on the right side, on the left side. You have the margin on the left side. Why you want to waste your time? If you want, make one small margin on your right hand side so that you do not move out from the paper, because sometimes when you're writing you tend to move out and you don't realize. Okay, so make one small margin on your left hand on your right hand side if you want, okay, like this, so that you are writing within this particular page section. Okay, otherwise left hand side margin is enough if you write the question number neatly. Now writing the question number is just not enough. You see, I have given the heading reduction of share capital. Two things are asked in the same question. Reduction of share capital, I have just put that, and I started only with the section. You know the section, write the section first. Automatically the examiner who is checking, this person knows. Understand the mindset of an examiner, okay. And you see the way I have written, and these are my writing. Handwriting is important. Say, suppose, okay, you all only give me the answer to this. Okay. To reduce. Okay. And I have seen a question answer paper like this. Okay, of a student. Okay, literally like this. You are an examiner. Now you are an examiner. You have got two papers. One, it is the way it is written here. One, the way it is written over here. What do you think will happen? Your content must be good also. Forget about the internal content. You must have written very nicely to reduce, extinguish the liability of the share capital. Okay, not paid up, etc., etc. Whatever it is, you know the section 66, but you did not quote it. Okay, you didn't even write as per Company Act 2013, it states so and so, so and so. You didn't even write that. You are just writing like in your normal own words. Your concept is good, but you are writing in the words where there is no legal connection to what the matter is there. So then how? Don't you think the person who has written the paper like this is going to get a hands above the papers which are there otherwise? First thing, I didn't understand only what is this, which answer, where, what, and not in, what is the, what are they writing? डू प्रॉपर स्पेसिंग, राइट इट नीटली, इट इज इम्पॉर्टेंट. ओके, सो इफ यू आर सेइंग टुडे दैट नो मैम वी आर राइटिंग इज ओनली लाइक दैट, सो प्लीज वर्क ऑन इट. हाउ विल यू वर्क ऑन इट? मेक नोट्स, स्टार्ट राइटिंग. डेली राइटिंग प्रैक्टिस इफ यू आर नॉट हैविंग, यू आर गोइंग टू फेस दिस प्रॉब्लम. सो देर इज अ सोल्यूशन टू द प्रॉब्लम प्रोवाइडेड यू आर रेडी टू टेक इट एंड अचीव इट अकॉर्डिंगली. ओके, नाउ सी दिस डिम्यूनेशन ऑफ शेयर कैपिटल. आई हैव रिटन द हेडिंग, स्टार्टेड ओनली विद द सेक्शन एंड देन आई हैव गिवन द कंक्लूजन, लास्ट कंक्लूजन. दस आर नॉट द सेम और इज द सेम वॉट एवर यू हैव टू गिव. ओके, सो इफ आई एम राइटिंग 15 पेजेस एंड आई एम नॉट राइट रिटन द वे इट शुड हैव बीन, माई 2 पेजेस आर सफिशियंट बिकॉज इट इज गिविंग एग्जैक्टली वॉट द इंस्टीट्यूट नीड्स इट. Now see the situational based. One situation is given, 3 marks. I finished this answer because see there is a question also, no, which I have written, but I finished this answer in 1 page. Okay. Now when you see this, hardly anything. I have taken all the facts from the situation only, and then given 1-2 things, you know, about the law. I have not stated any sections, but see the way I have written the answer. Please don't do something like dot, star. What is all that? Please avoid all this. Okay, don't do anything fancy in the paper. Okay, you're not writing any school exams. Okay, be professional. See, now again situational based question, 5 mark is there. In that B again 1 and 2 is there. Write, no, properly. Write answer number 2B. Question number 2B, answer number 2B, facts of the case, what is the provision of the law, what is the issue involved, and conclusion. 3-tier, 4-tier answer. Okay, facts, provision, issue involved, or you can just write facts, provisions of the law, and conclusion, whatever suits you, but write it in this form. Okay, whenever there is a situational case law answers, you are going to write it directly. Now, descriptive question was a direct question, but it was for 8 marks. So, I made sure that I am, see how I have left lines. I wrote one paragraph, I left one line. Again, I wrote one paragraph, I have not mentioned any kind of sections over here, see. But see the way I have written. Then I knew that there was one case, Salomon versus Salomon, facts, issue involved, decision. You can just write, see this, facts of the case, issue involved, decision held. Any case law, answer it in this. Facts, you will take it from the question. Then issue involved or provisions, you should know. And whatever decision based on that, you'll just give the conclusion. Okay. So see this. Now distinguish, my favorite. Okay. So distinguish. Students are like, ma'am, oh, distinguish, we have to write it paragraph. First, we have to explain partnership firm, then another paragraph company. Who said so? You have got some rule from ICSI like this? I don't know about some rule like this. Write a distinguish in the form, T form. You see this, I have given a point first. Meaning, and then I have explained both. Second, property. Agency, contract, lab, see the heading. Give the heading like this. Okay, so it is a 5 mark, it can be 3 marks. If it is 3 marks, give 5 points. If it is 5 mark, give 7 points. Okay, so this is how, and then yes. If we are going to write like this, it's going to take a lot of time. Yes, if all of a sudden on the day of paper, you will go and sit and you will write, it will take a lot of time. But same thing, if you would have had a practice of writing daily, and then you see the difference. Unless you are not going to practice, you are not going to get through. Okay. So you see this letter, draft type. They had asked us to draft one notice. So answer in the margin, name, number of the answer. Then date, I have given the notice. Whatever they have told, I have written that only, nothing new. They have given what is to be written in the notice. Nice. Okay. See this. Then there is problem based or practical question. So when there is a practical question also, write given, see given, then try to solve it. Whatever you get the answer, see, I put one pencil, the box. I made a box with the pencil. Don't use any color. No other colors, okay? Don't take green and blue and all that. Please use a pencil to underline anything which is important, and don't keep underlining on all the words. Not needed. It's really not needed and it looks ugly. So see that you are underlining the headings. If there is a section, underline the section, make a box for this type of answers. So when you read a paper like this, okay, and then there can be some informative type of question, same like a situation they have given, and you are supposed to give certain, on based on the situation you are supposed to write. Okay, this like this was again a practical only, but everything they have given over here, they just want the information from us that whether what they are doing is correct or no. So just don't write yes, what they are doing is right, no, what they are doing is no. Are baba, explain. Okay, so explain it how. See this. So this is how you are supposed to give the answers when you are writing the paper. You have to be mindful. Write the number of the question, the answer number which you are giving, whether it is 7A, 7B. In that B also, if there is 1 and 2, write it properly. Let the examiner understand that you are writing it professionally. Okay, when you know a case law, write the case law, underline that case law. When you know the sections, write the sections and write it properly. Companies Act, CA 2013, what is that? Please don't do all this. Companies Act 2013, you're supposed to write everything full form. Okay? So, this was the important thing for my today's mentorship session. Of course, I'm going to give you all some activity after this. Okay? So, exam presentation tips, paper presentation tips will come only when you are going to practice. So, if you all are wondering why is ma'am discussing all this today? Exams are yet to come, there is a lot of time, but you will have to practice from today to become perfect till then. Okay? So, I hope you all have found this session really, really very useful, very helpful. Okay? And please let me know in the comment section, like the video, and let me know in the comment section how it has been helpful to you all. You all can even come up with the suggestion of what type of other, you know, mentorship videos you would like me to make and help you. Okay, if you all want, you all have something in mind, please be free to share with me. Okay, any kind of doubts or there are some strategies which you are not able to unlock it, let me know, we can do it together. Okay, so thank you everyone for being there with me today. Have a great day. Bye.